Got them all. Oh, this looks beautiful. I was really curious, like, what they would have done. Wow. I saw beetles when I sprayed. Puffed smoke. Oh, those beetles. I brought beetle traps and Swiffer pads. Like, I brought all the stuff today. But I always take the time to kill any that I can get my little hive tool on. I don't just like, oh well. Because I disturbed them, you know, so. That's my fault, so I have to kind of take responsibility for that and kill the beetles. Wow. Impressive, girls. I've just been so impressed with this hive in general. They are just a powerhouse. Really amazing. So this one, it's not done, but the comb is all pulled out, not capped, but pulled out all the way to this last frame, which is just super impressive. And we've had a lot of nectar flow this year, so like, I get that that's why, but it's really impressive. So they get to keep this box, but I need the one underneath it. And the one underneath it is my half combs, and they look done. They look done. So what I'm gonna have to do is go get my fume board, take this box off, put it here, and then put the fume board on. So it's drawn and capped all the way over there. This one's half capped. And then in this far corner, they're still working on three of them. Okay, so I just sprayed this with Be Quick. I would assume this stuff lasts a long time for a hobby beekeeper. I just spray some on there. I've heard that these, like, solar tops don't really make a difference. I don't really know. I've heard people make these with just a box and felt. Or like a, not a hive cover, but like a feeding shim, and then you can just make it. I don't know about that. I don't know how that works. I have to go put some frames in a medium box.
Okay.
So I'm adding,
this is a whole box of drawn comb. I don't know if you can see that. That I've spun out.
We got 3.5 gallons off this. So if the fall flow, if they redo it, boom. Another 3.5 gallons. We'll see. Almost empty. But like I said, it's got to be like empty, empty. I guess I could blow through the cassettes and like blow them out. I can see. These cassettes have a piece of plastic. And you need to make sure that you get under that plastic, but not into the wood. Okay. I see a few little bees in there. We're gonna say that that's okay for now. Okay. We're also going to take some of these. Dealing with here. They have a whole full box of capped bulls, which is awesome, but they are kind of honey bound. They get mad if you, they're in the middle of licking up honey and you hit them, they're like, what? One is all honey but very thin. Thank you. be shaken and then brushed. True. You may not believe it, but the brush is, it cannot handle the brush. Go clean up in the hive, girl. Whew. This frame is heavy. Holding it with two little fingers. These two girls will not stop cleaning. Go clean inside the hive. Yeah, these girls. Get mad. So I'm not super worried. There's no burr comb on the bottom of this. I'm gonna very gently put these blank frames in here. This is the corner that I guess is the hottest. I don't know, but they fill it up with comb faster. I'm curious what's happening on the bottom of that. I don't know if there was brood or not, but I do not want to crack any more comb open. It's just kind of leaking all over. I was only going to take two or three frames, and I've got two. Going to give them a little bit more room, and they're going to have plenty of food because I'm going to leave a medium on here, and they have some down below also. I think I'll take this edge one if I can. Oh, that's cool. This bee has propolis on its legs. Ooh, I did not leave room to take this out. Almost dropped it. That's not what you want to do. Okay. What's nice about this is they don't brace comb much on here. Thing as I go. I was gonna do a mite check, but they're starting to get mad, understandably. So I probably won't. I can't pick up this box. I mean, it'll weigh less now that I have these frames out. Which means they're getting really ticked off. So you've gotta know when to back off. Oh, I dropped my hive tool somewhere walking. They're gonna need to draw out is on the edges. And maybe they'll move the honey to the edges. The comb in the middle is way too secured. It's got like tons of burr comb and brace comb, and I just am not wanting to do that right now. I would have to get the I would have to get the burr comb all straightened out. Where'd my brush go? Yeah. And if they don't draw these out, I can always give them back without the honey in them, because there's way too much honey in this box. They're supposed to do honey on the edges and brood in the middle, and they're just full on, and it's into the middle also. They've got about one more month to bring in this August harvest. I don't know if they'll make any more comb or not. They have made a lot this year. So I'm not, if I need to give them back their drawn frames, I will do that. But for right now, I'm gonna leave those in the middle. Honey on the edge there. These will be a little bit warmer. Right here, two new frames, a little warmer, maybe they'll draw them out. Honey on the end. And then we've got two on the end. They don't draw them out as fast over here, but if they don't draw them out at all, who cares? And I will give them back the frames. No big deal. Okay, I'm putting the medium that is mostly drawn out but needs capped back on. Okay, when you put it on sideways and start turning, the edges become a guillotine. Any bee poking their head out to see what the heck's going on will be chopped in half. Sometimes doing it slow still doesn't help. And it's really sad, because when there's an opening, they do stick their heads in it, because that's their job. They're trying to figure out why there's a air gap in their hive. Squaring up the corners. Okay, so almost all the way drawn out, almost capped. These are all drawn out. No work for the bees. This is for the fall flow. Oh, but I get to see that I did kill that beetle that ran down. Huzzah. So if you just go up and down, geez, there was a baby one. Hive beetles, man, they make you lose your mind. Ugh, I hate them. Well, there's three dead bees that got drug out. Sometimes when you're moving boxes around, you find bees that are already dead. That are just sitting there, and they just have not been taken out yet. So that doesn't necessarily mean that you did it. You might have. Should try not to, but I have noticed when I open the boxes, sometimes there'll be a dead bee, and I'll try to knock it off the hive, like out of the hive. And what happens instead is it gets knocked between the frames, and I'm wondering if it just kind of like falls down and then they take it out, whereas before they weren't really worried about it. Well, it's been raining a lot. They're bringing in pollen, which is awesome. I brought pollen patty, but since I'm seeing pollen, I'm not gonna do that. I'd rather not feed pollen patty. I'd rather them slow down brood if they need to. That's what they're supposed to do. Okay. Crank this thing down. I'm gonna go check the honey super on this other hive. It's not as It has not been my honey producer hive this year, so I'm not really expecting much. But I still have smoke. And I already have bees mad at me, so. And the beetles out. Only come see this hive in the spring. Hopefully they have a queen, because they are defensive. Let's hope. I didn't have much smoke. It's kind of my fault, but I looked down and there were like a bee or two trying to sting me, and I hadn't even pulled a frame out yet. I'm not into that.